A best-selling novel about adventure and survival get the silver screen treatment, and they got just the right director to bring this one to life. Hello there to everyone watching in the land of cyberspace. I am movie critic Nick Iacobucci, as always, for Real Screen Reviews and the YouTube channel We Live Film, and our next movie review is Life of Pi. This drama and adventure opened on Friday, November 21st, 2012, and it stars Suraj Sharma, Gerard Depardieu, and it comes to us from director Ang Lee, the Academy Award-winning director of Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, and Brokeback Mountain. Ang Lee once again goes back to basics and does what he does best, and that would be to tell a very dramatic story. This tale tells of a young son of a zookeeper who is lucky enough to survive a shipwreck. It seems this youngster manages to stay alive while adrift in the ocean by utilizing the efforts of one of the lifeboats. Unfortunately, he must also share this lifeboat with a hyena, a zebra, an orangutan, and a Bengal tiger. Well, people, I will begin with just how technically perfect this film is, and expanding on that thought, how Ang Lee rarely ceases to amaze me. As with most of his films, the narrative of the story and the visual style are about equally matched, and by accomplishing this goal, he gives his movies a wonderful and delicate balance rarely achieved in the hands of other filmmakers. Life of Pi is visually breathtaking, and it blends filmed footage and CGI almost seamlessly. This is one of those occasional instances where a film will click with each and every individual member of the audience for some certain reason in their life, and it is still worthy of being called artistic on top of all that. However, what is most impressive about the project is that it is wondrously brilliant to look at, but it is still packed full with substance and foundation of story. This film is very well written and adapted from the novel that I heard was said to be unfilmable. Writer David McGee has crafted a very confined script in reference to location and lack of characters, and even though it lacks many humans in presence, it is one of the more human stories to come around in quite some time. Life of Pi is just a great example of the human spirit. It touches on highs as well as lows, and it takes what could have been a basic story and multiplies it into the struggle for survival. Someone else that added much heart and soul to the film would be composer Michel Dana. His notes of music emphasize a perfect match scene after scene after scene, and this score added layers to a film already swimming in drama. Now, this is quite a remarkable story of inspiration, and it's really of no shock to me that it took a master storyteller to bring this tale into the world of live action. The special effects are not just flawless and stunning, they are jaw-droppingly real, and to call this movie eye-catching would be the decade's biggest understatement. Then the director of photography expertly combined his talent with the special effects to produce a story that never feels bland, boring, or repetitive. Most of the movie takes place on the water, and Life of Pi always felt new and fresh and never stagnant and complacent. Then the 3D gave the audience much more of a connection with the film and leave it to Ang Lee to actually infuse 3D into his movie. His use of 3D makes the technology almost part of the movie experience, and it is not used in a way of being a gimmick or merely a way to increase the ticket price. The performances in Life of Pi are also remarkable. Multiple actors portray the same character, and each is well above average in their own way. Younger Pi is portrayed by Suraj Sharma and is nothing short of a revelation, and Ang Lee picked him out of obscurity in an open casting call of about 3,000. Bringing to life the role of older Pi is Irfan Khan, and he is so much more than just a narrator. The younger version does have much more to do, but each shines and is well-rounded and complete as a character. Another character that is just as compelling as any of the humans is the Bengal tiger named Richard Parker. The filmmakers have amazingly blended real tigers with computer imagery to stunningly realistic effect. You feel for the tiger just as much as you feel for any person in any movie, and this brought a sense of worth into something that could have fallen flat as a piano that was out of tune. At around 2 hours, The Life of Pi was a grand story and a grand movie, and it works because of its human element. This film transcends basic religious overtones and crosses over into its own tale of faith and humanity. For me, this was one of the most wonderful movie-going experiences of the year, or of the last couple of years, now that I think of it. I just can't say enough good things about this movie. Nick's Real Screen Review is a perfect 4 stars out of 4, and that's for director Ang Lee's newest must-see film known as The Life of Pi. If you've enjoyed this review, please click like below and give me a thumbs up or subscribe to either or both We Live Film or Real Screen Reviews if you haven't yet already. Now, I'm sure that I will be returning soon enough with more movie and trailer reviews, and until then, remember, people, that I'm not always right, but only when it comes to the movies, and thank you for your attention.